All right. So, next on the list tonight, we got AJ Brown. We're going to get into a little top five discussion, but I wanted to kind of single him out before we got into this discussion to just see where everybody is. Like, how do you feel about him? Are you in? Are you out? Is he still in the top five? So, you know, I'll open the floor to the guest right off the rip. He seems semi-polarizing, and it'd be definitely easy to still stick with him from all the physical traits and what could be. But, you know, in, out, what are you doing with him? What are your thoughts? AJ Brown.
AJ Brown is so polarizing that we did half an entire show dedicated to just this man and this topic. We had Pat Fitzmaurice from Fantasy Pros on with Jerry and I, my co-host at the Dynasty War Zone. And we did, you know, what I'm dumping him off on a rebuilding franchise. Why? Because what do rebuilding franchises always have a lot of? Draft picks or really young players. And since every dynasty service under the sun, except me, I have him as my sixth, but I'll be honest, they have him as a top three, top five. I'm going to go take two first or a first and a really young guy. Like an Elijah Moore, if I can get like a top three or four pick in a super flex and Elijah Moore for AJ Brown, he's gone. I'll let you ride off into the sunset. That rebuilder thinks they've got their cornerstone wide receiver to build around, and maybe they do. I would much rather go get a guy we'll talk about here in a minute, like a Godwin, like a DJ Moore, plus the first that I think I get back with AJ Brown. You know, you take the talent, you take the shirtless picture with him and DK Metcalf ripped in the gym together. I'll gladly take the guys who are just simply putting up points week after week, not rooting against the guy, but in Dynasty, one of the best abilities is availability. And he's just had two knee surgeries in the offseason. And that's always my fear with these super athletic guys. Saquon Barkley's another one. I heard you and Robbie talking about it last week. You start getting that hamstring, the ACL. He had two knee surgeries in the offseason. Not that he's had an ACL, but you get my point. Eventually, that athleticism starts getting zapped away a little bit as you go into year four, as you go into year five. And can I get a healthier asset with less of an injury track record plus an additional piece of capital? That was what I've ultimately decided to do with my AJB.
Yeah. You got a little AJ Brown insight?
I'm holding.
Yeah.
I'm steadfasting.
That image of him shirtless etched in your brain?
No, I have like the image of him taking it 80 yards to the house on a handoff, you know? I have the image of him just crushing after the catch, crushing while the ball's in the air down the field. Yes, he's been banged up. He's definitely had a bad year this year, came into it under the gun. Never was right to even start with. Probably shouldn't have came back. Probably should have sat out longer. You know, these players are often a detriment to themselves. And you know, Vrabel's a guy. He's going to let the player probably do what he thinks is best. And he's a player's coach. And he just never could get right. It was never right. And then when he did come in, he played hurt, but it was awesome. And I know he played hurt last year. He missed two games, but he's just a freak, and I don't want to just rule him out for basically one bad year of injuries. You know, I don't want to just try and get, you know, obviously you're talking about getting a pretty big haul, and if you can go get one of these young stud rookies or something like that, I get it. I'm not mad at you. I'm not necessarily going to argue with you, but I gotta ride with my AJ Brown, I think, for a little bit longer.
I completely understand. Just for me, I look at his best season. It was last year, 70 catches in 14 games. Didn't crack 1,100 yards.
He had 11. Oh, that's air yards. Never mind.
He had 11 touchdowns. So a lot of that was buoyed by touchdowns. You know,
but that's he scores touchdowns, right? That's what I want. I want touchdown score.
I'm with you. Touchdowns are great. We're going to talk about DJ Moore here in a bit. Who doesn't score touchdowns? He gets the receptions and the yards. And is there some regression to the mean?
I don't know. I've got a drink.
Obviously, touchdowns are the hardest thing to predict. And you know, not necessarily.
He had 8 his rookie year, followed up with 11. And then he was hurt this year. What are you gonna? I can't crush my man for 1 year being hurt. I just can't do it. He's too good.
I don't want to crush him, and I don't want to give away the whole ship, but He is my wide receiver six. It's not like I have him as like wide receiver 12. Or
but
13.
How can he be your wide receiver six if you're trying to pawn him off on a rebuilding team, you know?
Because I can get – it's for me, I'm always going to build around points. It's points per game. That's how you win. It doesn't matter what their name is. How repeatable are those points? And then if I get the insurance policy of that additional first, I trust myself as a drafter. I trust my network of people I get rookie and college prospect information from. That's my insurance policy. So if I can give up AJB and his ceiling of, let's say, 18 PPR points a game, and I can get a DJ Moore with 15, I'm going to trade those three PPR points a game to go to have additional assets.
So is that just like simply risk mitigation on AJ
kind
Brown?
Somewhat of a hedge.
Yeah.
I'm going to trade the super duper high ceiling for a much safer floor, because I know going back to the old guys, I'm going to have some of those old guys that can really chip in. Adam Thielen this year, before he hurt his ankle, mm-hmm. was like the wide receiver eight, nine at the time.
Oh, look at all those touchdowns that he leans on though.
That's right. I just want points, and my fear is I don't want to look back with AJ Brown. So I love him. I had him at number one coming into the season, but just some risk mitigation.
Yeah, I did have him as – he was definitely my number one guy. I loved everything about him. It's whether or not he's going to be Keenan Allen or whether or not he's going to be Todd Gurley. And I know they're different players, and I know there was a different injury situation, but one is no longer capable of getting on an NFL roster, and one is still fucking slaying it.
Far from a bum.
Which one is going to be A.J. Brown? I don't think anybody could sit here with a straight face and tell you. You can't figure out what those surgeries were. I've spent a good 30 minutes, 40 minutes trying to figure out exactly what was wrong with him and what happened. And it's super vague. They kept it super close to the vest, which I guess I kind of like, but I'm also kind of scares me a little bit, because maybe if it wasn't as big of a deal that you wouldn't have been having to hold it so close to the vest, and that he could barely get through walkthroughs last year. And I mean, that shows you how fucking tough the guy is. But I mean, at the same sense, like, did he do more damage playing through that and being tough than just shutting it down and getting what he needed? Which you could look at that, you know, you might revere that or be like, you fucking idiot.
Still really young. And even if he was playing through all that and averaging 17.7 points a game last year, then imagine him healthy, you know?
So, yeah, well, I guess I'm saying all that to say that I can't quit him yet. I'm not a big...
Oh, no, yeah.
I'm not a big injury making decisions for me guy, but I also stubbornly, you know, just said, fuck it, I'm still in on Todd Gurley, and that burned me. So, you know, I could see it in both directions. I've been playing the game long enough to see it in both directions, but I like the shirtless photograph. I also enjoy that.
Oh, as a gym bro, I'm all in. I'm all about that shirtless selfie action.
But I also like the fact that he could take that 7 yarder to the house when he's in the open field. It seems like people just fucking bounce off of him. He's absolutely elite in so many facets of the game that I'm not able to quit him yet. And I think, you know, we're gonna get into the top five here a little bit in just a second. But I gotta, like I said, he's probably still floating right around that area, like he is for you. And I think last week, Robbie brought up a good point, which we kind of allude to sometimes, but like, people will be like, ah, you hated Javonte Williams because you had Najee Harris and Etienne over him. So, you know, you definitely hate Javonte Williams. And it's like, I don't fucking hate Javonte Williams. I just had those two guys over him. It's not that I hate him. Like, you don't hate AJ Brown. You're still telling us that you have him at six, you know? So it's, you know, But, you know, it's like, oh, fuck you, man. You got him at six? What the fuck's
wrong
with
No, it wasn't more that the six. It was more of the, I'm trying to dump him off. It seemed like it wasn't six, you know?
I mean, I'm not putting him on the front yard next to that old couch with a sign that says free next to him.
Or I mean, best
I'm
offer.
I'm not giving him away, but I'm looking.
Interesting trade.
Yeah. I'm seeing what's out there, especially in the off season. See, this is the exact opposite of the old dude conversation. Like right now, you're not getting, you would be moving AJ Brown for 50 cents on the dollar. But in the off season, again, hope springs eternal. And, you know, his value will go right back up to that where it should be. And people will be looking to 2022. That's when I would be looking to make that kind of move. Just seeing what's out there.
Yeah.
You know, nothing wrong with spicing the old group chat up with, hey, guys, AJ Brown on the board, looking to mix things up.
Yeah, so see what you can get. See what the old cast brings back there. You know, sometimes you just got to throw a hook in the water.
You know, you don't want, you know, what they say, desperation's a stinky cologne. I don't want to come across as desperate or thirsty to move the guy. I just want to, you know, see what's out there.
Yeah. Well, I can get that, but I think I'm still hanging on super tight with that rock hard bod, and we're gonna vibe out. So I'm still very interested in AJ Brown. Not that it's the most rational take. I think your take is probably a little bit more rational than what I'm putting out there. But I can't quit what could be, and maybe we'll never know. And maybe the smarter approach is to throw that line out there and see what. But I'm still grasping that with two hands. I tried to trade for AJ Brown in this offseason a few times in some FFPCs. Didn't quite get it done, which, you know, made the playoffs in a couple of those FFPCs, and I would have not if I would have made that deal. So, you know, again, sometimes it's the best deals are the deals you don't make. But all right. So just wanted to get a little AJ Brown talk out of the way before we got into the top five. So maybe that didn't dominate the top five conversation. So
let's go ahead and take a real quick commercial break.
Okay.
Or bathroom break, if you will.
Sure.
And we'll be right back. If you're listening on YouTube, though, you got to go to the next video. Appreciate y'all.